What's happening? This is Lightning Bolt Forever back again with more Star Wars Jedi Knight 2 Jedi Outcast Level 7 Yavin Trial. Alright. So, yeah, I gotta say straight away, I love this level. And this level, I'd say this is probably my favorite level in the game right here, because it's just, it's so awesome from the design right down to the music. The reason I love this level so much is because there's no enemies in it. It lets you go at your own pace, and it's just, it's so immersive. Like, you can tell a lot of thought went into these Yavin levels. I mean, they're just, they're so cool. But, anyway, yeah, and plus this level kind of familiarizes you with how the rest of the game is kind of going to play out. Because we need to complete each trial to regain our Force abilities and search the trial grounds for our lightsaber. Alright. So, yeah, and I will probably be, like, just gushing about the music throughout this video, too. There's one particular part that I really like. But anyway, let's go ahead and get started with our trials here. We can head in through this door on the left and go through here. And hey, check it out. We have our very first Force ability. All right, so we take a look at our data pad here. And yeah, we have just found Force Push. It allows the Jedi to push objects away from himself and defend himself from missile and Force Grip attacks. Rank 1. So we can head on through here. And, yeah, when you come into this room, this is the first of the trials. If you see an object with a, blue Force reticule highlighting it, you can, well, yeah, that means you can use the Force on it. So let's turn over all these stone panels here. Alright. And these show us a whole bunch of symbols here, and what we need to do is match up the symbols on the wall to the ones on the floor here with, the arrows. So this one is all matched up. Push this one here. Yeah, we can push this one. That one's matched. That one's matched. Yeah, that part you just heard there. That's probably my favorite.
That wasn't too bad.
Yeah, that wasn't too bad. But yeah, that's probably my favorite part about the music in this level. But anyway, yeah, here's our second ability. Force Pull allows the Jedi to pull specific world objects to him. And yeah, you can see our, we now have Force power in the bottom right there. But anyway, yeah, what I was saying about rank 1, if we go through here.
I think I see where I need to go, but how am I gonna get up there?
Simple. We will just use Force Pull on all the stone steps here, build ourselves a little staircase. But anyway, yeah, what I was saying about rank 1. Rank 1 is the lowest of the three ranks that we can upgrade our Force powers at. And the way Force power upgrades work in this game is a little bit different than how it's done in Dark Forces 2. In this game, you don't upgrade them yourself. It's not like you invest Force stars in them or anything like that. They pretty much upgrade automatically as you progress through the game. Yeah, up there is the only secret of the level, so we'll go ahead and get that out of the way. Just pull out the steps here. The stone stairs and jump up here. And yeah, you can pull the back to tank and the battery towards you if you need them. But anyway, yeah, only secret in the levels right here. And let's jump back down carefully. And yeah, we can grab our third ability right here, which is Force Speed. The Jedi speeds up and slows the world around him, which works a little bit differently than how it did in Dark Forces 2, because obviously in Dark Forces 2, the level didn't really slow down.
Skywalker sure didn't make this easy.
Yeah, the world didn't really slow down as so much as Kyle just ran like a crazy person. But anyway, yeah. Step on this pressure weight here, and well, yeah, all the doors are gonna lower. And if you take a look way out in the distance there, hey, there's something shiny in that cage right there. Maybe, could that be our lightsaber? Ah, we shall see. But anyway, let's use Force Speed and run past these doors before they close on us. Here comes my favorite part of the music here. Yeah, the cage back there, obviously we missed that, but oh well, we'll see what's in there later. Anyway, here's the last of the Force powers we'll be getting in this level. Yes, and as you can see, because of the fact that I'm jumping here, our last ability, which we get all the neutral abilities in this level, our last ability for the level is Force Jump. Allows a Jedi to make a tremendous vertical leap. And take a look at this. This is just normally jumping right here, and look how much higher we can jump because of that. That's just too cool. But anyway, yeah. Obviously with this game, just simply jumping allows you to force jump straight away. It's not like a separate ability, quote-unquote, like it is in Dark Forces 2. So let's get up here.
Yes.
Yes. All right. So we have made it up to the top here, and we'll go through this door. And we can head down here. And this takes us to a little bit of a tricky situation here. What we have to do... We're blocked off right here, but what we have to do... is use force pull on these statue heads here. Whoops, get up there, Kyle. And yeah, we basically have to draw the water out of those statue heads, raise up the bridge, and see, with the bridge raising up, so does the caged wall there. So what you want to do is use force speed and quickly run to the other side and jump. Alright, we made it. So yes, with that, that'll allow you to get up here quickly. And we can break down this wall here, fall on down here, and around this way. And this takes us to here.
I think they put the door in just a little too high.
Yeah, we have to get up there. So, let's go ahead and push in all these buttons here. And jump, whoop, come on, Kyle. Jump up here. Wah, just like that. And like that. And we made it to the top. All right. So we're taken to this little area. This is probably the most difficult trial, because it may take you a couple of attempts. What you need to do, and this will involve using force speed here, quickly head on around here. Use force speed, and stepping on that little plate there is going to cause this bridge to move. You want to jump.
Pretty tricky,
yeah. You want to jump up to here while that bridge is passing by very quickly. And that takes us out to here. And there's the cage that we missed before. So, let's see what's inside that cage. Let's push in all these pegs here.
That's what I came for. Now, how do I get it out of there?
Ah, yes, our lightsaber. That's what we came here for. And, there's an easy way to get that saber out of there. What we have to do is come over this way and step on this, step on this, this weight right here, and that's going to lift up the cage. Now, what we need to do is use force speed, and then when you get to here...
All that work, and now I still have to find a way out.
Use force pull on the lightsaber hilt there, and, that's how you get it. And picking up the lightsaber gives us three new abilities. Saber throw, which you pretty much know how that works. Saber defense, which allows us to block blaster bolts. And saber offense, which, of course, is just your classic hack and slash, like so. But, that's basically how you do it. So the way we get out of here is you have to cut these ropes with saber throw. Whoop.
I must almost be done with this thing.
All right, and we just head on through here.
It's locked.
Locked? No, it's not. We can just hack on through there. And that concludes the trials.
You've retrieved your lightsaber. Very good.
I'm ready. What did you find out about the sun?
Not much. With the help of your ship's logs and the Republic's databases, we've tracked down the registry of Dasan's ship to a Rodian named Relo Baruch.
Relo Baruch?
You know him?
Not personally. He claims to be an honest garbage hauler, but he's really one of the most powerful criminal kingpins in all of Nar Shada. Even the Hutts won't touch him.
Sounds like a solid lead.
It'll do.
Kyle.
Yeah?
I just wanted to say how impressed I was with your performance in the trial. Considering how long it's been since you used the Force, I almost expected you to fail outright.
Well,
you've been to the Valley of the Jedi.
Yes.
Kyle.
I know what I'm doing, Skywalker. If I'm going to defeat the sun, I'll need the full power of the Force, and I can't afford to spend years of my life retraining myself here.
Kyle, I realize you're in pain, but you must learn to anticipate the consequences of your actions. You and Jan swore an oath to protect the Valley of the Jedi, and now that Jan's dead, you're the only person who knows where it is. If you should fall to the dark side, you could use the Valley's power for unspeakably evil purposes.
Are you saying I can't be trusted?
I'm saying that I want you to let go of your anger before it destroys you.
I don't know if I can do that, but I will give you the coordinates to the Valley of the Jedi, just to be safe.
Well, that's a start, I suppose. Take one of the Academy's vessels to Nar Shaddaa. It'll be less conspicuous. Don't worry. I'll take care of the Raven's Claw until you return.
You're not coming along?
I'm afraid not. I have pressing business of my own to attend to. Good luck, Kyle. I hope you find what you're looking for. May the Force be with you.
Right.
Alrighty, so we have successfully reclaimed our lightsaber, and we've gotten back all of our neutral Force abilities. So yeah, it looks like we're pretty armed and dangerous now. So yeah, it's time to go after Relo Baruch. So when we come back, I will see you in level 8 Nar Shaddaa Streets. Till then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later.